Hello and welcome to AzureWala YouTube channel. We are in part 74 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 126 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 127. Question 127. You have Azure virtual machine named VM1 and recovery service vault named Vault 1. You create a backup policy named Policy 1 shown in the exhibit. So let's scroll down. Policy 1 backup schedule is on daily basis, having at 2 a.m. with UTC time zone. The retention for daily backup is 5 days. The retention for weekly backup is for 20 weeks. And it is the weekly backup is occurring on Sunday at 2 a.m. The retention for monthly backup point is occurring on 2nd of the month. And it would be retained for 24 months. So this is the retention 1, this is retention 2, and this one is retention 3. Retention for yearly backup is occurring on January 9th and it would be retained for 5 years. Let's scroll down. You configure the backup of VM1 to use policy 1 on Thursday, January 1st at 1 a.m. First backup would occur at 2 a.m. You need to identify the number of available recovery points for VM1. How many recovery points are available on January 8th and January 15th? So January 8th, we would like to check on 2 p.m. and January 15, we would like to check at 2 p.m. So let's understand how many backups are conducted by this and how many recovery points are available on this particular date on the given time. So let's go to our table view of the recovery. So this is the first table which shows the backups occurred between 1st of Jan to 8th of Jan. And since we are going to check on 8th of Jan at 2 p.m. so total number of recovery points we need to identify. So this is the first table which shows the backups occurred between 1st of Jan to 8th of Jan. And since we are going to check on 8th of Jan at 2 p.m. so total number of recovery points we need to identify. The first backup event is occurring on 1st of January at 2 a.m. and that is the daily backup event. The second backup event is occurring on 2nd of January. That is the monthly backup event. So that is the one copy is collected on that day. The third backup event is occurring on Saturday, 3rd January, and that is the daily backup event. The fourth event is occurring on Sunday, which is the weekly backup event as per the question. And on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday are the daily backup event happening. Now we need to check the available recovery points on 8th of Jan. I have marked all the available points in green, but I will explain it a little bit. So we have to check the available recovery points on 8th of January. So we can see 5 recovery points are available daily. 1, 2, 3 and 4, these are daily, and that includes the weekly one as well, because each backup is happening that will return one copy. On Sunday, weekly backup is scheduled. Therefore, daily and weekly one have one copy only. And definitely on 2nd of January, monthly backup is occurring. Therefore, it will keep one copy as well. So if we do the total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, we would have 6 recovery points available on 8th of January. Let's move to next table. For the 15th of January, we would check our backup copies available at 2 p.m. On 15th of January, we would have 4 daily recovery points available and 1 daily plus weekly recovery points available. Therefore, these all together would be the 5 recovery points, and 1 yearly recovery points would be available on 9th of January, which is happening once in a year. So that point would be available, so plus 1. And the recent weekly recovery point would be available, which has occurred on 4th of January. So this is one copy would be available. Next one is the monthly recovery point, which is the one copy has occurred on the 2nd of the month. So that would be available. Therefore, total recovery points would be 8 recovery points available on 15th of January. As we have understood on the table, that we would have 4 copies of daily backup and 1 copy which is the weekly plus daily and 1 copy which is the monthly backup. Therefore, total 6 copies are the correct answer. The recovery points which we are going to check on 15th of January would be like this, that we would have 4 copies of daily backup and 1 copy which is the weekly backup, and another 1 copy of weekly backup which is the from the previous week, which has occurred on 4th of January on Sunday, a monthly backup copy which has occurred on 2nd of January, and 1 copy which has occurred on 9th of January, that is for yearly backup. Therefore, we would have 8 copies available as a recovery point.
I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell notification icon. Thank you for watching this video. See you next video.